bilimlerinde onur doktorası da verilmiş Latin Amerika'da, Paraguay'da. Onu da eklemem lazım. Ben kendisini burada size aktarmaktan bugün uyuyacağım şimdiden. Teşekkür ediyoruz. Başlayabiliriz. Bir kez daha.
Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to say a few words as a beginning. I consider Mersin in Turkey my second country because I have brothers and sisters here.
Türkiye'yi ve Mersin'i ikinci evim kabul ediyorum çünkü burada kız kardeşlerim, erkek kardeşlerim.
Because I would like to thanks. First of all, to precious Sada Bilir and Aliyah Bilir and the members of the organization committee as the whole committee of the organization of the festival, including Rohan, Ozemir, and Lidan, and the law enforcement of mine, and especially colleagues, poets, as well as academics.
Saadet Bilir ve Ali Bilir'e özel teşekkürlerimi sunuyorum. Ayrıca da akademik ve sanat sonuçları paylaştığınız için eşim Orhan Özdemir'e ve bana da teşekkürlerimi sunuyorum. We thank you.
And I would like to say that the festivals like this one,
evet, bu festivalle ilgili söyleyecektim.
Proves that without interaction, there is no improvement of any culture.
Sanat ve böylesi etkinlikler olmadan hiçbir kültürde herhangi bir ilerleme olamaz.
Because if we do not interact.
Çünkü bir etkileşimde bulunmazsa.
Every culture will evolve from the inside.
Tüm kültürler, her bir kültür gözden yok olur.
Because all of us are red under our skin, regardless from which religion, or gender, or race we are coming from.
Evet, ırkımız, derimizin rengi, cinsiyetimiz ne olursa olsun, hepimizin derisinin altında kan aynı renk akar diyor.
That's I would like to underline that this festival is an excellent example for the rest of the world that you can unify diversities.
Bu festival ya da bu etkinlik dünyada bir sürü yere örnek olabilir diyor. Bu gayretiyle ve birleştirici özelliğiyle.
And as any professor, I talk too much, so I'm going to focus on this.
Ve kimle konuştuysam bu konuları herkes ilgisinde.
As you can see, the title of today's presentation is Social Media and Art Communication 21st Century.
Şimdi Profesör Haçari tek tek slaytlarla ilgili konuşurken ben onun konuşmasını kesmeyeceğim. Yani biraz önce yaptığımız gibi yapmayacağım. Bitirdikten sonra size anlamını yapmaya çalışacağım.
And before we continue, I'll just release one secret.
Başlamadan önce size bir sır vermek istiyorum.
And this is the surprise also for the organization committee.
Ve bu da organizasyon komitesi için de bir istiyor.
This festival here has the first opportunity to see one of my, this is only an announcement of the lecture.
Bu festival
the first to see this announcement of the lecture, this presentation, which will be from the next spring. Within the social media syllabus at the Nicolaus Copernicus University in Poland. And I will be teaching that syllabus
next
week. So not Bosnia and Herzegovina. Turkey is the first one that we are able to see one of this kind of presentation. So let's focus on the concrete issue. Social media use web-based and mobile technologies to turn communication into interactive dialogue, allowing for the creation and exchange of user-generated content and providing the structure for people to get organized, exchange, and collaborate. Social media allows the interaction on a global scale, make it possible for users to add content or commentary and to form groups quickly. Now, of course, all of you who are using social media know this. like it's not bad even to repeat it from the start. At the moment, some of the social media tools with which we are most familiar are online social networks, Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, LinkedIn, 500px, Dribbble, Deviant Art, MySpace, Snapchat, etc., etc. Blogs, microblogs, Twitter, etc. Sharing sites like YouTube, Flickr, podcasts, wikis like Wikipedia, and widgets, apps such as those available for mobile devices.
Sosyal medya, web tabanlı mobil teknolojileri kullanarak iletişimin etkileşimli bir diyalog olmasını mümkün kılmakta. Bu durum kullanıcıların oluşturduğu bir içeriğin yaratılmasına izin verir ve insanların organize olmalarına, işbirliği yapmalarına ve görüş alışverişinde bulunmalarına olanak sağlar. Sosyal medya etkileşimi küresel boyuta taşır ve kullanıcılar bu etkileşime içerik ve yorum ekleyip gruplar oluşturabilirler. Şu anda en yaygın kullanılan sosyal medya araçlarının bazıları online sosyal ağlar dediklerimiz Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, LinkedIn gibi bloglar, mikrobloglar Twitter gibi ve YouTube, Flickr gibi paylaşım siteleri, podcastlar, bilgiler ve widget uygulamaları olup bunların hepsi mobil cihazlarda da bulunmaktadır.
Social media have an impact on the arts from at least three different perspectives. They help bring audiences to performances and to artworks by matching art to people who are looking for it. They provide a platform to create art and to engage in debate and dialogue around communities of interest, and they give organizations tools to listen to the public and build art awareness.
Social media,
all artists bypass traditional gatekeepers, the calling companies, magazines, courses, media articles, etc. By placing artwork online directly, as many writers have noted, among them Richard Joel, in his book Six Pixels of Separation, the relative ease of placing material online has resulted in overabundance. People, including artists, have been given a powerful and mostly free platform to share ideas with the world and are doing so in droves. They find it easier to reach the public directly. They find themselves awash in a sea of content. Current writing suggests that social media provide important tools to help artists reach their audiences in this situation, predicated on the assumptions that there is no longer a mass market, but rather a collection of niche markets. In this view, audiences can fragment it and are not necessarily larger or smaller, just more diffuse. Social media are regarded as powerful because they allow artists to reach the specific audiences that are interested in what the artists
to
encourage people with similar interests to link up and follow each other. An opinion or a review on one of these sites is likely to more than receptive ears, just as a link to a video or a book is likely to find an audience. As Joy knows, it's the perfect dream for advertising. Match your products and services up to customers who are looking for them. Musicians, writers, video artists, and other artists who produce work that can reach the public directly through networks tend to use social media to cut through the mass of online material to bring potential audiences to their work. For example, by interacting with online communities that may be interested in the subject of a video or in a particular musical genre in which the artist works. Others, most significantly performing arts organizations, use social media to bring audiences to their performances by linking to groups they know to be interested in their art, for and by providing platforms that give audience members enriched material on the performances. Creation communities of interest is excellent for online, collective, and engaged art communities, which were among the first to use social media technologies, and contributed to creating and developing them. Social media platforms and free, libre, and open source software are widely used by smaller arts organizations, artist-run centers, art collectives, networks, etc., as they are accessible, user-friendly, and free of all costs. operating from common understanding that openness facilitates creativity, as communities that embrace close, offer shared values about accessibility. Via forums, mailings, church. But also in person through workshops and public shows and talks or jam sessions. Within these communities, recurrent events such as upgrades, dog bonds, and etc. kuchas, future knowledge sharing and networking among artists and technology professionals. Like commercial social networks such as Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn are ubiquitous across arts organizations, engaged and collective organizations also tend to use peer-to-peer networks, which are based on decentralized models. Here, the notion of peer-to-peer has spread beyond music and movie sharing sites to peer-to-peer funding, like Kickstarter, and to wikis, which allowed for collaborative writing and participation.
Online talk look like
we used to change and complement the existing communications activities of an organization. Given that many of these tools provide for two-way communication, they can be used in both active and passive ways to send out messages, engage, and gather feedback or monitor comments.
Tools like bir organizasyonun mevcut iletişimlerinin tamamlanması ve güçlendirilmesi için kullanılır. Bu araçların iki yönlü iletişim sağladığı dikkate alınmalıdır. Yani hem etken hem de bilgen bir biçimde kullanılır. Mesela iletiler gönderilir, geri bildirim alınır, yorumlar izlenir ya da eklenir.
Many social media channels include built-in metrics, so they can also be used for measurement and reporting. Social media can help to monitor the organization's reputation, listen to artists and other stakeholders, gather feedback, raise awareness, and change distribution visibility. Resistance is final and is future, and the only thing we can do is to adapt to or to be crushed under the wheels of history. Internet then seems to be particularly dangerous technology and instrumentalized human. Also, art can instrumentalize both. It's adequately presented for the good of all.
Çoğu sosyal medya kanalı ölçme ölçme ve raporlandırma için de kullanılabilir. Söz konusu organizasyonun bilinirliği, şöhreti izlenebilir. Sanatçılar ve diğer paydaşlar dinlenebilir. Geri bildirim toplanır. Farkındalıklar yükselir. Ve dağıtım ve görülebilirlik güçlendirilir. Bu alanda direnmek boşuna bir çabadır. Ya uyum sağlayacağız, yani sosyal medyanın gücünü kabul etmeli, ya uyum sağlayacağız ya da tarihin tekerlekleri altında ezileceğiz. İnternet insanoğlunu ayrımsallaştıran, yani iradesini kontrol altına alan özellikle tehlikeli bir teknoloji olarak görülmekte. Ancak sanat eğer doğru bir biçimde sunulursa bu araçsallaştırma herkesi
it has been criticized ritualization, dematerialization of the communication, a devaluation of physical space, manipulation with personal data which are resulting from the alleged chaotic structure of the internet, raising the boundaries between public and private, real and virtual. Social networks and new media are not observed as termination and change of media technologies, but final confirmation of the rule of mass media.
İnternetin sözü monağı karmaşık yapısından kaynaklanan kişisel bilgilerin manipülasyonu ve sanallık özelliği, yani iletişimin metalaşması, fiziksel alanın değersizleşmesi eleştiriliyor. İnternet kamu ile özel arasındaki gerçek ve sanal arasındaki sınırları silmekte. Sosyal ağlar ve yeni medya teknolojisinin solu ya da değişimi olarak gözlemlemekte. Bilakis sosyal kitlelere hitap eden medyanın kurallarını onaylanmasıdır. Artık kitlelere hitap ediyor.
If the first response is pessimistic vision of the end of the history of media, as we know, the second one is an optimistic picture of the overall connection and participation.
ممكن تختيب الصورة بس بالتليفون طبعا.
In the real world, and a powerful weapon in the process of empowering of the user.
Burada Cerveş'ten bir alıntı var. Medya tarihinin bildiğimiz geçmişinin son bulmasıyla ilgili kötümser bir görüş ise ikinci görüş tüm bağlantının ve katılımı olmasının iyimserliğiydi. Bu gerçek dünyaya sanatsal bir müdahale aracı ve kullanıcıyı güçlendirmek bağlamında güçlü bir silah olarak düşünüyorum.
Also, postmodern age have been declared as the era of no confidence in the great stories. The story of the internet have been shaped as a new big story or meta narration. As it has been noted by McLuhan, of course, in 1964, the print media decontextualized the messages which need to be recovered back into the context, the situation of free two-way communication. In the cyberspace, according to many of McLuhan's successors, we can talk about a global village, a new quasi-tribal holistic society.
Önemli hikayelerde postmodern dönem özgüvenin olmadığı bir çağ olarak belirtilmiş olsa da internetin öyküsü bir büyük bir öykü olarak veya hikayeleştirme ötesi olarak şekillendirilmiştir. McLuhan tarafından belirtildiği gibi yayınlanmış iletişim araçları iletiği bağlamından kopararak bağlama yeniden dönmeyi gerektirdi. Yani bağımsız iki yönlü iletişim durumu söz konusu. Siber alanla birlikte McLuhan'dan sonra gelen görüşlerin çoğuna göre küresel köylerden yeni kabileleri andıran üçüncü toplumdan bahsedilebilir.
In the era of information capitalism, there has been transformation of the cultural industries itself, which is why that digital media and network media are often seen as the materialization of the idea of openness, the implementation of individual freedom of so far underprivileged users of mass media.
Bu yüzden de genellikle dijital medya ve ağ medyasının açıklık fikrinin somutlaşması ve iletişim araçlarının ne kadar az ayrıcalıkları içinde kullanılması olarak görüldü. Ağ bir kültürdür.
The network is a culture. The battleground where negotiations are taking place is the dominant and subordinate groups. And the result of this negotiation is uncertain. To understand the paradox of a culture for the media, it is important to assist with the significance of culture as a subject more complex than it first appears. The ruling ideology has never been able to transform the popular elements, but will not go so far even if it attempts such a thing. For journalism, that meaning the transformation of authentic speech into a calm stereotype, ready-made and neutralized over populism. While it is for faithful transformation of authentic practices of free connection between two points in the network. In front of us is also a warning of the possibility that internet converts us into obedient ants, referring to the collective consciousness that uncritically digests toxic information. When we compare the process of introduction of food in the digestive tract and the process of entering information into the brain, it is evident that evolution spent much more time working on nourishment and information learning, as was written by Niels Bohr. Rudits are today considered technophobes and skeptics, opponents of technological development and trust in the technological scientific paradigm. The logical conclusion is aimed towards the creation of a healthy society, a society directed to the common good through the individual doing, especially through art culture, observing three cultures of the networks, the idea of free information, the acceptance of a culture of resistance as critical observation of ideological matrices, which are directed towards manipulation, regardless of whether they come from the political left or political right, as the network is a tool for life management of mere mortals. During the work towards education of educators for the benefit of society as a whole and further education of the population, starting from primary school and continuing further. This is to think about as well with an understanding of the use of social media for the benefit of the art communication in the 21st century as well. Thank you for your attention.